really nice to people when we are preaching today. And when I look at the book of Matthew chapter 23, I noticed that from verse 13, the way the Lord was talking to people, it was not like sounding nice. He said, but woe unto you, Pharisees. 14, he said, woe. 15, he said, woe. 16, woe. 23, woe.
Okay, now I responded to that yesterday. He said it to the Pharisees only because they don't repent. But he did not say to his disciples. And then to even the people who are weak, he will say, people weak faith, but when you have faith, like a mustard seed, you can move mountains. So those words are not for the disciples.
Yeah.
When people repent, he doesn't talk like that.
Yeah. But when we are preaching to non-believers, we have to be nice.
Okay. Now, woe to people is people who know God and knowingly reject God.
Exactly.
When we preach to non-Christians, we don't say woe to you. We will say, God cares about you. God wants to bless you. And God is real. He can come to bless you. So in many evangelistic meetings, I will invite people to come up and pray for them. And sometimes I demonstrate by praying for two persons and then ask them what the experience, and then encourage other people also come out, I can pray for you. So we want to bring blessings. Only when people knowingly reject God, and then I tell them, there's a danger. There's a danger. You can lose salvation, and you can face the eternal punishment of God. So I will warn them. And woe to people is only when people unknowingly attack the church, attack Jesus, because the Pharisees are doing that. That's why Jesus said to them. But that's, so you notice the heavy words in the Bible. As I said yesterday, even when Jesus talked to Jerusalem, oh Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you have killed the prophets that have been sent to you, and you have stoned to death the people that sent to you. But I want to gather you like a hen want to gather the chicks. So even when he talked to the Israelites, he talked like this. And in the book of Isaiah chapter 1 is the heaviest book, chapter. Isaiah chapter 1 is the heaviest chapter on sin. And warn these people. These people of sin, that you are bearing sin, all this punishment is coming on you and you don't repent. But then he says at the end, though your sin is like scarlet, but it will be white like snow, like white like wool. Now, this is unbelievable because God has a lot of blessings. He knows that these people are misguided. They have problems. But the Bible has warnings. And God said, I will punish. But the punishment is for your good, so you can repent. And if you look at book of Jeremiah, we talk about a lot of punishment. Still, God gives them a lot of assurance of blessings and forgiveness. If you repent, then blessings will come to you again. So God always wants to bless us. It's only for people who don't repent that we warn.